Hey folks, this is Shane, and today we're playing Rockman X4. As I mentioned in the third, we'll be playing through a Zero this time. Ready? Now, this happens to be one of my favorite games in the series, and I feel a lot of people share the same sentiment. It's either this one or the first one for most people. I actually remember my first experience with the game. I saw it on the shelf in a Hollywood Video, and I couldn't believe there was an X4. My friend David and I loved playing the original trilogy on Super Nintendo, so I couldn't let the opportunity to play the newest installment pass me up. Right off the bat, I picked Zero. It's pretty common to be able to select multiple characters in the X games nowadays, but at the time it was a pretty big change to the series. It was so cool to have an opportunity to play with him as an alternate character through a level just once in X3, and now we had him as one of the main characters. I remember getting to this part and being shocked that Zero said damn. Remember, at the time this game came out, I was only 8 and damn was still a grown-up word. Remember the Ninja Turtles movie? Raphael was such a badass just because he said damn a few times. Another change this game introduced was splitting levels up into two areas, kind of like the Sonic the Hedgehog series. Levels are divided into two acts, if you will, the second one usually being pretty different from the first. As you can see here, the first act of this stage had the futuristic sci-fi city background, where we now have an almost post-apocalyptic scenario. The ceiling's falling apart. Stupid robotic bees are flying around everywhere. Platforms are shifting all about. There are laser hands on the wall, rubble you have to blast through. And the ground wants to collapse and give you extra lives and full health. To top it all off, the walls are closing in and you have to perform some impressive wall jumping to make it out alive! Okay, it's not that chaotic at all. Now we have Iris, who will end up being our navigator later. And... boss time! The warning siren before the fight is also a new introduction to the series. I've heard the PlayStation version can actually get stuck on the warning signal. Didn't have that problem with Saturn, did ya? Now we must face Erigyon from the first act. He was the giant flying robot in the background that was chasing us around. You can actually attack him the first stage if you wait around. He'll slam his claw into the ground and then you can attack it. Honestly though, there isn't much of a point, because even if you defeat him in the first act, you still have to fight him in the second, so why waste the time? Boom, and enter Colonel. Colonel is Iris' brother and second in command with Repliforce, a Reploid militia created by Dr. Kane to increase Reploid efficiency. However, now they're being blamed for the attack in Sky Lagoon and being branded as Mavericks. This concludes the opening stage of Rockman X4. Hop onto the thread and tell me which Maverick I get to hunt next. This has been Shane, have a great day.